We all sat down together. We heard that there was going to be some sort of big announcement from the Prime Minister. We put on the TV and it started.
Good evening.
We knew it wasn't going to be good. And now we know why we knew it wasn't good. Because he's got a flag. That was the start of it all. Don't get me wrong. I'm not upset about this whole Tory obsession with having flags anyway. I can't wait until one of the backbencher MPs does a piece on a news channel and has Jerry Halliwell getting changed behind him. It's going to be fun. And I'm not against the flag. I really would like to see our flag be no longer synonymous with racism. I think it's hugely annoying and wrong that we have a flag that people think means a bad thing. But if you want the flag to not seem racist, maybe you should get fewer Tories using it. That might help a little bit. We're in charge of the flag, maybe fewer Tories. Boris Johnson said,
"The coronavirus is the biggest threat this country has faced for decades, and this country is not alone."
Yeah, we are. We Brexited. Can't remember who it was who got that done. Weird. But I'm not saying that it would be better if we were still in a trading bloc that would make it illegal for the EU to stop the movement of goods, let's call them vaccines, from continental Europe to the UK. I'm not saying it would be better if we were in that group that meant that we couldn't be stopped from Actually, no, I am saying that would be better. I'm definitely saying that would be better if we could get the damn vaccines we paid for.
"From this evening, I must give the British people a very simple instruction. You must stay at home."
Yeah, that was it. That was the moment that everything changed and we were told to stay at home. And we stayed at home. Unless it was slightly sunny, in which case Bournemouth looked like that. And even when it wasn't sunny, we stayed at home unless there was a park to go in because people liked the sun. But it was also not just people going to the park. Shopping got busy. But other than that, we stayed at home and it changed things forever. Do you remember when Boris Johnson said this?
"And use food delivery services where you can."
And we did. I think he might have meant Ocado and Tesco and whatnot, but that's not actually how we've been eating for a year. We use services a bit more like this.
"Somebody say just eat."
"Somebody just did. Ordering the food for myself and my fat kid. Don't want to get up off my big butt. I'm comfort eating all my feelings till it ends up in my big gut. I got my drivers on the down low. He's got a gyro. He's on furlough. Oh, I place my order then I chow down. Cause we're in lockdown. To boost my feelings when I get down. There's just one problem from what I see.
What you got, sir?
We got obesity. My daily exercise can jog on. I'd rather log on and get my nose back tied on. I'm overeating now for God's sake, and I'm in bad shape. Wine counts as a portion of grape. Diabetes gonna take my feet.
Did somebody say just eat?"